Today we are discussing about fluidity of plasma membrane. This fluidity of plasma membrane is dependent upon three things. The first thing we have is the concentration of saturated and unsaturated or unsaturated fatty acids. Second thing is dependent upon length of fatty acid chain. And third thing is dependent upon concentration of cholesterol. So these are the three factors which determine the fluidity of the plasma membrane. Let's take the first one in detail, is the concentration of saturated and or unsaturated fatty acids. See, if we have a plasma membrane, like we have a plasma membrane here, this plasma membrane is having more saturated fatty acids. That means if you see here, the saturated fatty acids are there, a straight chain of fatty acids is there. So we have a straight chain of fatty acids, means it's a saturated fatty acid lipid barrier here. So if you have these lipid barrier which is consisting of or containing a saturated fatty acids, so we can say there is more compactness because of the hydrophobic interactions between the lipid barrier or fatty acid chains. So it becomes more compact, so it is less fluid. But it is more compact means it's having high melting temperature. So whenever you have to provide the temperature so as to break down its hydrophobic interactions or to have changed into this unsaturated form, for that you have to provide the temperature. We call that temperature as a melting temperature, and we also call it the melting point. So if you take a saturated fatty acids, see for this, if you take first a saturated fatty acids. Saturated fatty acid jo hote hain, inka jo TM hota hai, melting temperature, ya jisko hum bolte hain ki melting point jo hota hai inka, wo bahut high hota hai, about 25 degree Celsius. So agar hum in fatty acids ko dekhenge, they are solid at room temperature. Wo solid hote hain at room temperature. Or we can also see the saturated fatty acids have high transition temperature. So here we both said them, they have high transition temperature. That means apni distinct state ko change karne ke liye unko zyada se zyada temperature hame dena padega. Second one we have is the unsaturated fatty acids. Unsaturated fatty acids jo hote hain, they have carbon-carbon single bonds as well as double bonds. Say if you take a saturated, it's have carbon-carbon single bonds. So compactness is there, thickness is there, more melting temperature. So if you take unsaturated fatty acids, they have carbon double bond, single bond as well. So we can say they have less compactness. Mean less compactness means their melting temperature, they have less thickness, means their melting temperature is very less. The melting temperature we have is TM value for them is approximately about 5 degrees Celsius. So we can say they have a less transition state or less transition temperature. Transition temperature hota hai, wo bahut kam hota hai as compared to the saturated. And the very important point, that is they are liquid at room temperature. Room temperature pe kya hote hai? Wo liquid hote hai. So whenever you have to differentiate them, the saturated fatty acids have high melting point or melting temperature. They are solid at room temperature. They have a high transition temperature. You can also call it. Unsaturated fatty acids, they have a melting temperature 5 degrees Celsius, they are liquid at room temperature, and they have a less transition temperature. Say for instance, agar humare paas koi cell hai,
which lives at high temperature, कोई भी सेल हमारे पास अगर है वो एक हाई टेम्परेचर पे लिव करती है, या कोई भी ऑर्गेनिज्म भी आप ले लो आप, विच लिव्स एट हाई टेम्परेचर, एट हाई टेम्परेचर हमारे पास प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर कौन से फैटी एसिड्स होंगे और कितनी फ्लूइडिटी होगी वो हम देखेंगे. से फॉर इंस्टेंस वी हैव ऑर्गेनिज्म, एक ऑर्गेनिज्म हमारे पास है या कोई सेल है विच इज लिविंग एट हाई टेम्परेचर, लिविंग एट हाई टेम्परेचर. तो अगर ये हाई टेम्परेचर पे रहती है तो इसके अंदर कौन से टाइप ऑफ फैटी एसिड्स होंगे प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर. सो प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर मेनली जो फैटी एसिड्स होंगे दैट विल बी सैचुरेटेड, लेकिन दे कैन रेजिस्ट द हाई टेम्परेचर, दैट इज व्हाई. सो वी कैन सी दे हैव अ सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स. तो अगर सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स है तो इसका मतलब ये है कि अगर ये सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स है तो एक स्ट्रेट चेन है फैटी एसिड्स की, जैसे मैं दिखा रहा हूं आपको एक स्ट्रेट चेन है फैटी एसिड्स की, और यहां पे आप देखोगे वी हैव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग हाइड्रोफोबिक इंट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द लिपिड बैरियर और बिटवीन द फैटी एसिड चेन, एक स्ट्रॉन्ग हम देख रहे हैं हाइड्रोफोबिक इंट्रैक्शन है. तो उसकी वजह से ये जो हमारे पास स्ट्रक्चर है मोर कंपैक्ट है. अगर मोर कंपैक्ट है, मोर सॉलिड है, तो इसका मतलब यह है कि इसके पास जो फ्लूइडिटी होगी वो लेस होगी. सो इफ वी हैव अ प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन और द ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच इज लिविंग एट हाई टेम्परेचर हैव अ सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड, मींस इट्स हैविंग अ लेस फ्लूइडिटी ड्यू टू द कंपैक्टनेस और ड्यू टू द हाइड्रोफोबिक इंट्रैक्शन, मोर हाइड्रोफोबिक इंट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द फैटी एसिड चेन्स. If you have to increase or if the cell have to increase the fluidity, which thing should be done to the plasma membrane or which thing should be added to the plasma membrane? So the most important thing is if you have an unsaturated plasma membrane or if you have a lipid bilayer which is having an unsaturated fatty acids, you want to increase the fluidity of this plasma membrane or this lipid bilayer. So the cholesterol molecule should be more in between the fatty acid chains. So if the cholesterol is here, what will happen? It will interfere with the hydrophobic interaction. See, for instance, if I am taking here in a lipid bilayer, see, if we have a cholesterol here, it's a long, elongated fatty acid. मैंने बताया था आपको, elongated fatty acid, elongated lipid है ये. तो अगर आप इस cholesterol को देखो, it's mainly associated with the sphingolipid because they're also elongated one. मैंने आपको बताया था. तो अगर ये in between fatty acid chains में आ जाएगा, so it will interfere the hydrophobic interactions of the fatty acid chains. अगर hydrophobic interactions fatty acid chains का interfere करेगा, so ये lipid molecule freely move करेगा, और ये lipid molecule भी freely move करेगा, और जितनी lipid molecules freely move करेंगे, तो हम ये बताएंगे कि fluidity increase हो जाएगी. So if that increase, the cholesterol should be added. So cholesterol increases the fluidity of plasma membrane due to interference, due to causing interference between hydrophobic interactions of fatty acid chains. So interaction जो fatty acid chains की है वो interfere करेगा कौन, cholesterol, तो automatically ये free हो जाएगा, थोड़ा सा move करेगा, so fluidity increase हो जाएगी. So याद रखना, at high temperature we have a saturated fatty acids which create the less fluidity in a plasma membrane. To increase the fluidity, the cholesterol comes in between the fatty acid chains, which interferes the hydrophobic interactions of the fatty acids, keeping this lipid molecule free to some extent, and it shows the movement, so increase the fluidity of the plasma membrane. Second thing we have, if a cell or an organism is living at low temperature, which type of the fatty acids are present inside the lipid bilayer or to the plasma membrane? So we'll study this point as well.
So next point we have is a cell or an organism it is living at low temperature. अगर ये लो टेम्परेचर पे रहता है तो प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर कौन से फैटी एसिड्स होंगे? द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन इज हैविंग अ फैटी एसिड वी कॉल देम एज अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स बिकॉज दे आर लिक्विड एट लो टेम्परेचर अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स ये तो कॉमन सेंस है. अगर सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड हाई टेम्परेचर में है तो ऑटोमेटिकली उनमें कॉम्पैक्टनेस ज्यादा है तो वो रेजिस्ट करते हैं हाई टेम्परेचर को. अगर सैचुरेटेड लो टेम्परेचर पे होते तो ऑटोमेटिकली वो तो सॉलिड पहले से ही है तो लो टेम्परेचर को मोर सॉलिड इफेक्ट करता तो उसकी वजह से जो मूवमेंट है वो रुक जाती. तो अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड इसलिए यहां पे है. रीजन ये है कि अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड लिक्विड रहते हैं एट लो टेम्परेचर तो इसका मतलब ये है कि फिलिपिटी मेंटेन रहती है ट्रांसपोर्ट मेंटेन रहता है एक्सचेंज ऑफ थिंग्स थ्रू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन इजिली हो जाता है. So if you have an organism living at low temperature, means they have unsaturated fatty acids. So agar inke paas unsaturated fatty acid hai, iska matlab isme high fluidity hai. High fluidity. Because if you take an unsaturated fatty acid, jaise maine aapko plasma membrane dikhaya aapko, to unsaturated fatty acid ke andar aap dekhoge we have a kink. We call this one as a kink. Band hai bilkul. It's called because of the double bonds between the carbon and carbon. So kink hai, to kink ki wajah se hydrophobic interaction is strong nahi hai, to loosely hai. To agar loosely hai, to automatically it's more fluid. Kyunki hydrophobic interaction is strong nahi, compactness utni nahi hai, thickness utni nahi hai. To automatically it will remain liquid at room temperature. So it is more fluid, the things will easily diffuse in and out. Ab agar hum dekhenge yahan pe cholesterol ka kya role hai. So when you will see that role of the cholesterol here in an unsaturated fatty acid. So if we will add it to cholesterol, agar yahan pe cholesterol aa jayega in between, say this is a cholesterol molecule which comes in between here. So agar cholesterol aa jayega, so automatically it will increase the rigidity of the plasma membrane. And rigidity, when the plasma membrane becomes rigid, what happens? It becomes less fluid. So the cholesterol here increases rigidity. Or rigidity ki wajah se kya hoga? It will make it as a less fluid. Iski fluidity jo hai wo bhi decrease ho jayega. Let me say there will be decrease in fluidity of plasma membrane. So greater जितना भी आप cholesterol यहाँ पे डालोगे, अगर ज्यादा cholesterol डालोगे तो automatically fluidity effect हो जाएगी. यहाँ पे ज्यादा cholesterol डालोगे तो interference ज्यादा हो जाएगी, तो fluidity increase हो जाएगी. This is a difference. You have to keep in mind. Second more important thing which we are, so this is जो मैंने आपको बताया कि fluidity जो है असल पे तीन चीजों पे depend है, unsaturated और saturated fatty acid. वो मैंने बताया आपको, clear किया आपको. और दूसरी चीज मैंने आपको जो बताई दैट इज cholesterol, मैंने आपको बताया कोलेस्ट्रॉल कंसंट्रेशन पे भी डिपेंडेंट है. अगर सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड है कोलेस्ट्रॉल उस पर डालोगे तो फ्लिडिटी इंक्रीज हो जाएगी. अगर अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड है तो कोलेस्ट्रॉल डालोगे तो रिजिडिटी इंक्रीज हो जाएगी, तो ऑटोमेटिकली फ्लिडिटी कम हो जाएगी. सो इफ वी हैव सेल्स विच आर हीट रेजिस्टेंट सेल्स, अगर हमारे पास हीट रेजिस्टेंट सेल्स है, तो अगर आपको कोई बताएगा कि हमारे पास सेल है दैट इज हीट रेजिस्टेंट सेल, उसके अंदर कौन से फैटी एसिड्स हैं, मेनली कौन से फैटी एसिड पाए जाएंगे इन द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. सो वी हैव हियर सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स, सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स आर प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ हीट रेजिस्टेंट सेल बिकॉज दे रेजिस्ट द हीट, बिकॉज अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू रेजिस्ट हीट बिकॉज दे आर थिकनेस, दे आर कॉम्पैक्टनेस. सेकंड थिंग वी हैव, if we have a cold resistant cells, cold resistant cells have more unsaturated fatty acid. Unke paas hota hai unsaturated fatty acid because they keep the plasma membrane fluid in a low temperature.
So you have to keep in mind, heat resistant cells have more saturated fatty acids, cold resistant cells have more unsaturated fatty acids. So if the question is asked in an examination, the question pucha jayega exam ke andar, aapse puchega ki humare paas ek bacterial cell hai, hum usko grow karate hain 20 degree Celsius pe. Ab humne us cell ko nikala wahan se, now we are growing him at a 37 degree Celsius. To aap hame bataye plasma membrane ke andar kaun si change aa sakti hai, what will be the change in a plasma membrane? Plasma membrane ke andar kaun si change? Say, if we have a bacterial cell, humare paas ek bacterial cell hai, ye bacterial cell grow kar rahi hai at 20 degree Celsius. Ab humne isi cell ko nikala, now it is growing at 37 degree Celsius. Hame kaha jata hai, what will be change in the plasma membrane of that cell? Change in plasma membrane of that cell. To hum ye batayenge ki jab wo 20 degree Celsius pe grow kar rahi thi wo bacterial cell, to wahan pe jo fatty acids the, that were unsaturated fatty acids, more unsaturated fatty acids. Unsaturated fatty acids with short chains. ये आप याद रखेंगे, इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है कि एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट आप से, कि अगर आपने बैक्टीरियल सेल को 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस पे ग्रो कराया तो उस टाइम पे प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के अंदर कौन से फैटी एसिड्स होंगे ज्यादा? अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स होंगे और विद शॉर्ट चेंज. अगर आपने इसको चेंज किया, आपने इसको ग्रो कराया 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस पे, तो कौन से फैटी एसिड्स? सिंपल सी बात है, 37 इज अ हीट रेजिस्टिंग, सो वी हैव अ सैचुरेटेड fatty acids with long chains. Maybe this question may be asked in examination. The question is very easy. If a bacterial cell is grown at 20 degrees Celsius, okay, and the same cell is taken out, then grown in a 37 degrees Celsius, what will be the change in the fatty acids of the plasma membrane? So see, we have, see the answer is here. 20 degree Celsius पे हमारे पास unsaturated fatty acids होंगे with short chains, और 37 degree Celsius पे हमारे पास saturated fatty acids होंगे with long chains. Now tomorrow we'll discuss about the asymmetry of the plasma membrane.